Hey guys, I have been working in the garden all morning and I wanted to show you what I've been up to. So I want to take you on a garden tour of what my garden will be looking like for 2022. So let's go. Hey guys, I just stopped by Dunkin' Donuts to get me an espresso coffee. I have had a busy morning. I have been up early out in the garden and now I'm headed to the nursery. I already went to the nursery earlier today, but you girls know, and you men too, once you get out in the garden, you start thinking, oh my gosh, I didn't get enough of this. I didn't get enough of that. Even with the best of planning, sometimes you end up back at the nursery two or three times, right? So this is my second time going back today. So I thought, hey, let's make the most of this, and I'm gonna take you guys with me. So let's head to the nursery and see what goodies they have. Earlier, it was packed. They had so many beautiful things, but I'm gonna tell you, I went the beginning of the season, gardening season, and I racked up. And I got all of the best stuff. And that's a tip. If you want the really good stuff, you gotta go early. The early bird catches the worm. So, y'all, excuse me. Everything is looking, you know, wild in the garden. Even this hair, no makeup. Hey, I'm a glam girl. I like to get my stuff together. So for me to be on camera like this, y'all, but that's what you got. You gotta take the good, the bad, the good, the pretty, you gotta take me all, right? So we are headed to the nursery. I'm so excited. It looks like it's gonna be raining. I mean, I got my garden boots on, y'all. I'm ready. I'm ready for the day. I'm ready for the garden life. You know, when you see this hat, it's on and popping. You know that your girl's been in the garden. Anytime you see this hat, it's gardening season. Although I do like to wear my hats when it's, you know, the sun is out, just because we have to protect our skin, guys. And we cannot afford to damage the gold, the goodness. I know they say black don't crack, but we still gotta keep it together. We still gotta do some things, right? All right, so I will check back as soon as I get to the nursery. I've gotta go to the Publix because my son has sent me out to get him some things for lunch. You all know boys always gotta eat, right? So as soon as I do that, I'm gonna head to the nursery where we're gonna have a little bit of fun. All right, guys. Okay guys, so we're here and I'm about to get out the car, get my purse, and I'm gonna show you around the nursery. This is our local nursery. It's always full and plentiful, especially this year. It's Cedar Creek Nursery here in Lena. And yeah, so let's go take a look. Okay guys, these are the mandevilles that I'm looking at. They're so gorgeous. And they're great for layering pots and containers. Perfect. All right, so I am looking for Creeping Jenny. Let's see. Oh my gosh, aren't those so beautiful? They need just a little bit of love. What are these called? Lilies, okay. And these are all of your herbs right here.
Down.
look for some sweet potato vines. I don't see any creeping. Jenny, maybe we'll look up. But that's always the first to go.
I find a plant, which I don't think I'm going to. And if I do, I'm going to go plant that.
All right, girl. All right, I'll see you Monday. Super Bells. And this is how it can be toward the end of the day. Everything starts to get gnawed and picked over. Let's see. Here's some sweet potato vines. I'll just get a few of those. Try to pick a healthy rack of them. More plants, but I always love to look. It's okay to look, right? Oh my gosh, lamb ears. I need some of those. Oh my gosh. Aren't those gorgeous? See, this is what happens when you come into nursery. You always leave with something you did not intend to get. They did not have the Creeping Jenny. They sold out this morning. Should have got it on my first go around, but I forgot. It happens, right? But this is why you have to get to the nurseries early in the morning, because everybody and their mama, their great grandmama, everybody out there trying to get their garden looking like something. So I ended up getting sweet potato vines. I wanted the Creeping Jenny, but she said they'll probably have some more next week. I could have went to like a big box store, Lowe's or somewhere to get it, but I'm not doing all of that. We're just going to work with what we have and make the best out of it. You can't go wrong with a sweet potato vine either. So yeah, I'm going to take you all with me and back to the house. We're going to play in the soil, get in the garden, and yeah, I just wanted you to see our local nursery. They tend to always have it fully stocked, but like I said, people get up early in the morning. They get their day started, they get what they need, and so by what, 2:30, 3 o'clock, you get the leftovers, people. You get the leftovers. All right, see you in a bit. Hey guys, good morning. Welcome to a new day. I wanted to do something different today. Every year I show you all my garden, so I wanted to show you what the 2022 garden is looking like. I'm so excited. I went to the nursery this morning, I stocked up on some goodies, and so I'm gonna show you all what I've been doing all morning. I hope it gives you some ideas. I love to do it. It's therapeutic for me. I love to get out in nature and talk to God and meditate and just get my hands in the soil. So yeah, let's take a look at what I've been doing this morning. I planted some supertunias this year. Aren't they beautiful? Now these are gonna spread out gorgeous. And my husband, this is new, he put some hay planters up for me because I wanted to have some more room for potting. And so these are just room savers, and they also look beautiful on your patio because these will trellis down and they're gonna hang down, and it's gonna be so whimsical and fairy tale like. I love flowers. So right here we have Super Bells, and I have Bordeaux. I think this is called bubble gum, and I have it layered with sweet potato vines. And so yeah, now on my patio I have planters, and this year I'm planting strawberries. I always have herbs, and I have lemon balm, cilantro, rosemary in these pots, strawberries, and just some pansies. In pansy season is almost up, sadly, so these will go, and I will probably replace them with another type of flower just to bring the pollinators in. Right here we have ornamental kale and the pansies. I have stevia sweetener. That's where you get your stevia, but that's what it looks like. It comes from that plant. We have violas and rosemary and cilantro. And I always like to put my herbs and vegetable plants. I like to mix them up with flowers to attract the pollinators, and that way they all get live and everything grows so beautifully. These are just left over from the winter, and so their time is up. That's ornamental kale, and a lot of times it'll just stretch out and grow, and yeah, it's time for that to go. So I don't know what I'll put in these pots. Probably tomatoes, who knows? Tomatoes, eggplant, cucumbers, something like that. I typically plant a lot over there. Let me zoom in my larger in-ground planters. But this year I'm giving the ground a rest. It's been producing for me for like the last 7 years. So that is gonna get a rest. I'm just gonna cultivate the ground so that it will be ready for next season. But until then, we'll be using these to plant. And just so you know, you don't have to have a large garden. If you don't have like somewhere to plant, get pots, get large pots, plant in them. They work, guys. I have grown corn in pots. I've grown tomatoes. I've grown cucumbers, watermelon, strawberries. You just wanna make sure you get a large pot. So if you don't have a large in-ground area, don't fret. Get yourself some large pots. And I got these from Costco last year for $19.99 because I knew this year that I wouldn't be planting in my in-ground, and I wanted to have something big enough to plant my vegetables for 2022. So yeah, and so I have lined up all of my hay planters. They're gonna look beautiful toward the end of the season, and I'll do another video so you all can see how the plants progress. Because right now they're so small, but by the end of the season, y'all, they'll be hanging all the way down. They'll be just wide, spread out beautifully. So yeah, my husband did that for me last weekend. He even put one up today, and I have two more that he's gonna put up. As you see, they're everywhere along the patio. So let's go down. All right. And here are my pansies and violas. Like I said, I'm gonna have to replant because they're fading out, but they were so beautiful all winter long. And I love them because all winter long, for those of you who love flowers and color, you do not have to just go with your typical greenery, but in the winter you can still have color with pansies and violas, and they're so easy, y'all. I even have them down here in some of my planters. And I didn't have to water them. Nature, Mother Nature took care of them for the most part, you all. They're super easy. All right, so right now we got like a mess. I'm working, guys. This is a work in progress. And so I'm just planting these mandevilles. They're gonna be beautiful. I'm gonna layer them with some supertunias and some green trellis type of plantery. So I'm excited about how these are gonna look. They're gonna be gorgeous. I'm gonna put them by the door. Right here are my sweet potato vines right here. These are beautiful for layering or just on their own. They're really pretty. They spread out gorgeously. There's the train again, guys. Oh. Right here I have supertunia and I have black cherry, which these are gorgeous, y'all. And this is like, I don't know, what is this? This is daybreak charm. How pretty are those, right? These are like purplish sweet potato vines, and I'm gonna use that to trellis my plants. These are pansies. They're still looking good. As long as the ones are in the shade, I think that they can preserve a little bit longer. But I've had them since, I guess, August, September. And so yeah, their time is winding down. And you see right here, these have faded out pretty good. And that's what happens, and they start to shrink. They start to wither back, and you know that it is time to replace them. Now right here, I bought this from Lowe's, this whole pot right here, for $25. It was regularly like $100, but I tossed them down because it was the end of the season and it looked like it just needed a lot of nurturing. So a tip is, when you're at these big box stores and the plants look like they are in need of some love, ask for a discount, especially if it's toward the end of the season. So y'all, I got this like 2 years ago. It is still producing for me every year. And I do believe this was supposed to be an annual, but because of the zone we're in, it comes back every year. And these are the new ones that are coming back. So I will take all of these fall babies, and I'll take them out so that it will make room for these to grow back. But I wasn't even expecting that, you all. And they have been growing back in every pot that I bought, because I have like four of these. I bought every one that they had because it was such a great deal. Okay, these are my hibiscus. Right here, these are gonna be like nightingales, really blue and pretty. Here are my lime lights, my favorite hydrangea in the world. They're beautiful. They'll be super white and pretty and ice cream looking at the bottom like a strawberry pink and then white at the pinnacle. Gorgeous. These are my super tunias, guys. I love super tunias. That's why you see them everywhere, because they spread out beautifully and they give you a lot of bang for your buck. And I'm all about getting the most for my money all season long, because if you know gardening and flowers, it ain't cheap. So yeah, I'm all about getting the most bang for my buck. So this is super tunia Roya Magenta. And I love the Proven Winners because they're just a good brand and they give you high quality, lots of blooms, and they're long lasting. So when I see Proven Winner, that is my preferred brand. But you know, so yeah, those are more super tunias. So let's go over here. All right, super tunias, Bordeaux. These are more hydrangeas. I have hostas right here that are coming in. And so these will be really pretty. They'll be a shade of purple, guys. So it'll match this purple. So we got like a little purple theme going on over here, as you see. And let's take a walk by the tree. Now, you see my pansies? They look so sad, right? And I'm sad to see them go, but these are gonna have to be replaced, and I'm still thinking about what I should replace it with. If you have any ideas, I'd be welcome to hear from you. But of course, I'm thinking about my super tunias and maybe some more hostas, maybe a variety of different types of hostas at this particular tree, so I don't have to worry about planting so many annuals. Would be really nice, because that gets expensive. So I might do something like a variety of hostas that I can depend on to come back every year. But right now I've got coleuses that I've planted in the meantime, which they spread out really big. I have purple heart. I love purple hearts. And I may go get some more purple hearts and just do a whole row of them at the edge right here, because they spread out and they're a great layering plant and they look pretty. So I think I am gonna do that all around this bed. That's exactly what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do purple queens, because they will spread out and give me a lot of value for my money. So yeah, let's keep going. And keep in mind, the yard is a work in progress. We got a lot going on, a lot of bare spots we're trying to fix and trying to sod up. So yeah, it's coming along though. You don't like anything, everything's a process. Right here I have my hydrangea from last year with some creeping Jenny. These are my violas and oregano. I'm sorry, and violas. I'm gonna have to replace these as well. And I'm thinking that, I don't know what I'll do. Maybe I will do hibiscus. I love hibiscus, so probably so. Right here we have hydrangeas, limelight, as you all can tell. I'm in love with limelights. They are my most favorite plant ever. I love hydrangeas. All right, so here are the rose garden. It needs some work. I'm working on it, but they are doing wonderful. Got some hibiscus right here. So yeah, I've got to do some pruning, but look at the blooms on here. They're doing so beautiful, right? So I've got my little wild roses garden. This is like my wild area. I like to do a lot of wildflowers, so I am still planting in this area and deciding what I'm gonna do. So I'll do like bits of color of wildflowers over here to accent the roses. And then those little green patches are they're called Black Susans, but they look like sunflowers. And so I'll do that, and I'll have some pottery that I'm still looking at to go over here in this section. So this will be like my wildflower section, but I'm not finished up with this area, but you'll get to see it as I proceed. I have monkey grass right here in hostas. I'm still trying to revive them. Some of them got burnt out, but it will be looking good before the season's over. And I've planted sunflower, the gigantic sunflowers. They get taller than the house. They're like 8-10 feet tall. And some of them bigger than that, 15. And I love to see them. The kids love them because they're just so fascinated with sunflowers. So I do them all along here. And so right up in here, we'll have sunflowers. So yeah, again, I'm gonna be treating these planters this season. I'm not going to be growing anything in them, so we'll see what I'll do with that. Normally I'll do like cucumbers and something to trellis that little thing right here, that shape, that awning. And it's so pretty because you'll have vines going all around it to the point you won't even see the awning. But I don't know, you know, sometimes I think about roses, accenting it with roses so that it could be filled with roses. But I don't know, work in progress. All right, so here is another part of the garden. And you see these hostas, you all, a month ago, they were so tiny, itty bitty. I wish I could show you what they look like. They were so little, okay? And now it's like monster in 4 weeks. Now, I planted these 2 years ago, so this is the third year, I do believe. So remember when you plant things the third year, they come back bigger, stronger, your perennials, because that's the year they're gonna thrive. So yeah, that's exciting. The third year's always exciting. We have more super tunas, hydrangeas. Yeah, so still working on this bit. All right, so let's go down. Let's see what I wanna show you next. Okay, my favorite tree. On our property is this beautiful, call it my Moses tree, my burning bush, but it is my Japanese maple, and it is gorgeous. Look at that, look at the leaves on that, gorgeous. Okay, so those are the hostas again. I just love looking at them. I can't believe how big they've gotten. All right, so let's go down. Let's take a look at the fire pit area where I've got some goodies down there that we could take a look at. This is a hot mess. Like I said, don't judge me. It's gonna look gorgeous when it's all said and done. And gardening is a process, you all, like anything. Like, we still gotta mulch. We still gotta put down pine straw. There's still stuff to be done, but you do it little by little. You do it in stages and you get as much as you can get done day by day. Rome was not built in a day. And then guess what? Before you know it, you look up in the summer, the middle of summer, and you can enjoy the fruit of your works, right? So down here, we've got super tunas, hostas. Now, it looks real bare right now, right? But when we come back and we take a look at this maybe midsummer, these are gonna be spread out and they're gonna be looking amazing, okay? So it's good to see where you start, because sometimes, like anything, you forget where you start and it looks so little and it looks so insignificant. But if you keep going, just keep going, you look up and you're like, oh my gosh, I have built an empire, right? You know what I mean. So anyways, right here we have pansies and pots, hydrangeas. And yeah, I've got to do something with this bush right here. It's dying on me. I don't know if it's going to come back. So I think I'm just going to take it out, because I really don't need it there, because we've got these hydrangeas. So I'm just going to take it out. You know, sometimes you lose stuff, guys, and you got to know when to let it go. So I'm going to let that one go. Right here, we have a beautiful pot, an azalea. When it blooms once a year, it's beautiful. But then you get to enjoy the height of this. And greenery. And I like to do what they call thrills and spills and all of that. The thrill is the height, then you layer it with a spill that flows over, and then a filler like these pansies to go around it, and that way you have a layered pot and it looks gorgeous. But yeah, these pansies, they're doing so good, y'all. I'm gonna let them be great. I'm not gonna pluck them up right now, but you know what, their time is coming to a close. But be great, be great. And so right here, dead things from last season that have to be uprooted. Beautiful hydrangea that's coming back. It's so green. It's going to be beautiful. And so, yeah. I have a lot of potted flowers. I have a lot of things in ground. I love potted flowers just to play around with. So I've got to do something with this container. And yeah, so this azalea just last week was banging, and now this week no blooms, but that's how it is. It cycles off, cycles on, so maybe in a week or two we'll have more pretty blooms. This is a baby Japanese maple, and I forget what kind it is. I bought it a year or so ago, and it has survived the storm, y'all. It is hanging on. An Acer, yeah. But yeah, it's trying to do its thing. Right here, another hydrangea. We have hostas. I love a hosta because they come back every year and they just do their thing. They're so easy. Low maintenance. Ferns, gotta love them. I love a fern. We're in the South, so it's just traditional. In Southern homes, you're gonna see a fern, right? So there we got hostas, hydrangeas. And I'll come back and I'm gonna show y'all midsummer what the garden's looking like, but those hydrangeas are gonna be gorgeous when they're blooming and beautiful and full, and you have the white flowers. They're just gorgeous. So yeah, let's go take a look back up the stairs. This is my workout, y'all. Gardening will get you in shape. It will keep you toned. Right there, my planters, my husband, he has been busy planting those for me, and I love him for that because I always have something for my honey to do. The honey-do list, you ladies know what I'm talking about. But right here are my planters, and they're gonna look gorge when they start to fill out and they start to trellis down the railing. It's just gonna be so pretty and whimsical. I love that. I look forward to that. So yeah, this is just a little bit, like I said, we still got a lot of work to do. We've got to do the final things like putting the mulch down and the pine straw, which is not the fun part of the job. For me, it's the making things pretty, planting color, but then you got to do the upkeep, right? So yeah, we've got to do that. I've got to get some stones that I'm going to line this little section up with. And yeah, and like I said, it's a process. We got a lot to do, but we'll get it done day by day, month by month, and yeah. So let's take a look at the front patio, see what I got going on. These were the potters that I was saying that I got a good deal on from Lowe's, and so I'll take these back and we'll put them by the fire pit. But yeah, I'll have to replace or take out these because look at them, they're fading. They did me so good. But right here you have an hydrangea, so I'll just take these out and probably layer it with some creeping Jenny. But yeah, they've worked hard for me this season. All right, so let's take a look. I have a lot of pots, planters in the patio entry. So right here I have my hydrangeas layered with super tunias and some leftover pansies. So those are really pretty. I have hydrangeas in this pot, so I've layered them with super tunias, and those will be pretty. They'll trellis the pot. Right here, look at my pansies, y'all. They've been so good to me all season, and these still look good, so I'm gonna rock with them until they just decide they wanna quit. They're gonna stay, but look at that one. It's so pitiful, so I have to replace that today. It just hurts my feelings looking at it. It just looks so sad, but it works so hard for me. And right here, we have silver, I forget what you call this. It's called silver something, creeping Jenny, super tunias, so cute, so pretty. Pansies again. Right there, you have the silver accented with creeping Jenny and super tunias. So yeah, right there by the door, I have like those little trees. I forget what you call them, northern lights, I think. And I have super tunias there, so we'll layer them some more. Not sure what I want to do with that, but yeah, this is my front porch. I love to come and sit out here and just read a book or just read my Bible, do my devotionals, and just, yeah, it's nice, it's quiet, watch the kids play in the neighborhood, listen to the birds. So yeah, we've got a lot to do, just some little updates, but I wanted to show you what the garden was looking like for 2022. So I hope that this gave you all some ideas, and a lot of people say, well, I don't have a green thumb, but just pray about everything. The Lord will give you skillful hands, and that's what I love about God. When we acknowledge Him in all our ways, He makes everything we put our hands on to thrive, and we learn and we grow, and we learn so much about Him even through the process as He teaches us using nature. So just, you know, don't give up if you haven't had the best of luck. We all start somewhere. Just start and be willing to learn and pray about it, and God will help you to establish the work of your hands. Well, all right, guys, I pray that you all are having a beautiful Saturday. And I just wanted you all to get a look at the garden and see what I was up to today. You all have a blessed day. Bye. Oh, one more thing, guys. I wanted to show you one more thing. My window planter. I love it. Right there at the top of the house. I wish I had more, but the boys don't do a good job of watering it, and it's such a pain in the butt, but I love that. Anyways, okay guys, y'all have a blessed day.
Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess, Jesus is Lord.